On May 20th, Steinberg is discontinuing support for the e-licensor. If you got into Cubase at version 12, 13, or 14, and you never had one of these, don't even worry about it. If you do still use a dongle or a soft e-licensor and you're still kind of confused about what to do, here's an overview with some actionable steps. By the way, I sound kind of weird because I've been having cold after cold, but this information is too important not to share, so here you go. Option A, you love the e-licensor and you want to keep using it. What's still possible for you? First of all, you will still be able to update your products if you register them in your My Steinberg account ASAP. To do that, go to the Steinberg website, sign into your account or create a new one, go to Products, register e-licensor, then you enter the number of the e-licensor, which you can find in the e-licensor control center. If you plug in your dongle, the number will appear on the left here, that number goes here, and then it'll register all the licenses on that dongle. Next, reactivating a product with the e-licensor will no longer be possible. So if you already registered your product but you need a new installation, for example if you got a new computer, then you get a new activation code to reactivate it in the control center. If that sounds like something you were planning to do, you need to do it before May 20th. And third, you will not be able to transfer a product license from one dongle to another. Which means if you have licenses on several dongles and you want to move them to just one dongle, you need to do that now. If you want to move a license from the soft e-licensor to a dongle, you also need to do that now. And what if your dongle stops working after May 20th? Steinberg says you'll be able to get personal support, but only if your e-licensor is registered in My Steinberg, and you still won't be able to switch to a new dongle. And lastly, what happens with your soft e-licensor products? Steinberg recommends you move those to a dongle because that won't get you in trouble when you're getting a new computer or a new operating system. Okay, on to option B. You want to say goodbye to the e-licensor and start using the new system. The new system got introduced in 2022. It's called Steinberg Licensing. That must have been a long meeting. And this system makes it easier to use your licenses on different computers and all that good stuff. So how do you switch from the old to the new system? I'm gonna focus on Cubase. Of course, you can also have licenses for instruments and content packs, but let's say you're on Cubase 8 or 11, which is the last version in the old system. To make the switch from the e-licensor to Steinberg licensing, you do need to upgrade to the latest version, which right now is Cubase 14. So you have your current license in the e-licensor control center, which you also need to update to the latest version for everything to work properly. You bought an upgrade to Cubase 14, you installed the Steinberg Download Assistant, which you can get on the website, and then when you input the download access code, which you'll receive, you can just follow the instructions and the switch shall be made. Steinberg says you can even do this kind of upgrade after May 20th, as long as your e-licensor-based product is registered in your My Steinberg account. So actually, you don't even have to rush it.
In conclusion, if you haven't already, check your licenses and see what you want to do with them. And one thing everyone should do is register their products in My Steinberg, and we'll all be all right. Catch you next time. Bye.